Hi everyone, this is Arcadius, and today we will be reviewing the German cruiser O-Class, or as I have renamed her, Leine. Now, this cruiser is kind of special, and I say that because she is only one of two cruisers that can equip 15-inch guns. Yes, this ship can carry battleship guns. The only other one that can is Kronstadt. But honestly, those aren't all that are chalked up to be, I feel like the 11-inch guns are a lot better. So let's take a look to see what we have. 62,800 health, 90% torpedo resistance. Looks like max of just about 8 inches armor. A belt armor of 190 millimeters. So that's what? Almost 8 inches still. It's about 7 inches or 7.5. So that's pretty respectable. However, you still will take major chunk damage as well, so you want to keep in good angle as much as possible. Guns. The first part of this video, I'm going to use the 283mm 11-inch guns. You can see the stats here. And then for the second half, I'll be using the 15-inch guns. These guns are really good, and they can shoot out to 19.3 kilometers. Secondary battery range is 5.5 kilometers. Now, remind you, this is coming after P-Class, which has secondary range of 7 kilometers. So you lose 1.5 kilometers of secondary range. So that's pretty significant as well. There are 6 inches on the side. I don't think you have any 4 inches. No, so they're all 6 inches. And though they're not, they may look like they're significant, they're not really. You also have torpedoes. Now you have 4 triple launchers. You have one on each side of the beam. And then you actually have 2 mounted triple launchers in the bow. The angles are kind of wonky, but they're still there and they are pretty powerful. Speed of 35 knots means you're extremely fast. And your torpedo, your anti-aircraft defense is really impressive as well. AA stats on this ship are no joke. And you can run her with hydro or defensive AA. I do like to run her with defensive AA, mainly because you can knock down so many planes. You have normal repair, normal heal. I do have her with gun rotation and reload. However, if I used to use the 15-inch guns, I may head towards accuracy at that point. On all, this ship is really, really fun. Just keep in mind you have quite a bit of side that is quite easy to shoot. So you always have to keep that in mind. So let's toss her into a game and see what we can do. Alright, here we have ourselves our first game. 2 battleships and 5 cruisers. Honestly, pretty easy game. This cruiser is actually a really good high explosive spammer. She may not have that much effectiveness overall. You will hit some really heavily armored targets and it'll just shatter. But if you get it right into the superstructure, you can deal quite a bit of damage. And even if you're not good with high explosive, your armor piercing will do quite a bit of damage as well. So your guns turn pretty quickly. Your torpedo angles. Yes, this is quite the mess you have, and I don't quite understand it either. But I do know that you have one launcher here, one launcher here, and one all the way over here. There we go. So you have 4 launchers total. It kind of be kind of a pain to use them all. And like I said, it's not clear to see where the angles are all the time. But they're not terrible. It's just weird how they have it set up. It's hard to understand. Alright, so let's see what we have. Frederick de Gros, Missouri, Minotaur, Leine, Takao, Fargo, and Fargo. The deadliest thing is probably the Missouri. I do have health buffs and speed buffs applied as well, so keep that in mind. Also, these cruisers don't actually get any fighter consumable at all. So you have no kind of air cover. All you have is your defensive anti-aircraft defenses. Alright, so our torpedoes are loaded. She's a really pretty ship as well. Not as pretty as P-Class in my mind, but not a bad-looking ship still. Alright, so the first salvo is out. The shell velocity is not hard to work with either. And I just love the 12-second reload. It just... It's a rapid-firing 11-inch Scharnhorst. The ship is pretty much the same size as Scharnhorst, but the same guns. It's just a lot better, a lot faster, more torpedoes, better AA. She can still equip Hydro, but she can equip anti-aircraft defense if needed as well. You just don't get the prism benefits of a Scharnhorst. There we go, we got a fire and 10,000 damage just in high explosive. Now, I prefer to smother my enemies with rapid fire instead of concentrated volleys of devastating fire. So for me, I prefer the 11-inch guns, but I used to like her when she had the 15-inch guns. But you can go either way, honestly. In this case, Hydro might be better instead of defensive AA because you're not always going to run across a carrier, but you're always going to run across a ship that most likely has torpedoes. But I prefer to have defensive AA because this is a big ship and she doesn't turn all that well. So having what little maneuverability and defensive ability she has to help her with minimal damage, I guess you could say, or to help her diffuse the damage. Alright, so this site is clear. Double fire. That's nice. Let's see what else we got. We could try and hit the Missouri. Accuracy at long range is not going to be the best, but you're still going to be able to hit. Alright, and now we're getting back into the battle here, which means our accuracy should be going up a bit. Some consistent damage as well. Now this ship may seem like she wants to be a brawler, but she really just doesn't have the armor for it. Her bow armor cannot effectively bounce 16-inch and a higher shell caliber. So for example, this Missouri or Frederick the Gross, if they shoot me straight through the bow, it'll go straight through my bow and do a ton of damage. So we're actually getting in secondary range of the Frederick the Gross, which I don't really want to be in. So we'll set two more fires on her. And then we'll see what we can do to take care of these couple cruisers. Another double fire. You can see how easy it is to be an HE spammer with this ship and the 11-inch guns. Right, let's see if I'm getting a little bit more. Almost 10,000 damage. No fires, though. That's fine. And we'll launch one set of torpedoes. You do have two sets of torpedoes, we didn't go over that, but honestly, just choose whichever ones you think is best for you. For me personally, more damage is better. Alright. And we'll finish up this Missouri. Well, we won't even need to use torpedoes. Awesome. And there we have a game. So that was with the 11-inch guns. 209,000 damage, 2 ships sunk, 102 shell hits, 4 torpedoes, 3 aircraft shot down, 9 fires, 1 flooding, 2 modules destroyed, 59 secondary hits, over 5,000 base XP. You can see literally most of the damage came from shells and fires, with only the last little bit coming from torpedoes. So she's definitely a good HE spammer. So now, actually, it looks like we only have one option for torpedoes. My mistake. I think the original version of the ship had 2 options. That's why I was confusing it. Alright, so now let's toss her into a game with the 15-inch guns. Alright, and here we have ourselves another game. This time we have a carrier, a lot of battleships, only one cruiser, and quite a few destroyers. So let's see what we can do. I'm going to switch to armor-piercing since we do have the 15-inch guns. And let's see what we can do. What battleships do we have? Alsis, Freddy, and Misery. Alright, so the Freddies are going to be a problem. Their secondaries are going to tear me apart from the superstructure down. So I have to try and deal with them first, or at least keep them at a range where they're not a threat. Which destroyers do we have? 2 Tashkents, 2 Fletchers. Alright, not a problem. And then Taiho. We can easily knock down those aircraft, but there's still maybe some that get through. So we'll have to keep our eye out for that as well. Though I have a feeling the carrier is going to be on the right side. Now, I don't think I've actually played the ship with the 15-inch guns yet. But I did play the original version when they were testing her, and it seemed to work okay. But we'll see if there's any major changes. So it's pretty much just like a super gunize now at this point. Oh, I didn't select accuracy, so I still have reload and rotation. Alright, so yep. I should have gone with accuracy, as I completely miss. But even without accuracy, I was able to get 6 overpins on that Tashkent for a pretty solid amount of damage. So let's see what we can do against Leine. Not bad, not bad. So too much lead in that case. But that's fine. Alright, so let's see what we've got. I've got another Freddy here. A Fletcher and a Missouri. Let's start working on this Freddy. Gosh dang, I really wish I went for accuracy because that's just absolutely dreadful. Going to try and avoid the torpedoes that are coming my way. The maneuverability is pretty good, so I should be able to do that. AA is going to town. We should be expecting, yep, some plane kills. Alright, I'm not getting the big damage numbers that I'm expecting here, which is kind of unfortunate. Alright, so we got quite a few citadels there. And now we're just finishing up here. So we should be able to finish off this Missouri. Yep, we're getting quite a few citadels. Our secondaries may be able to take care of that. Now we're in the secondary into the Freddy. And you can just see how they're just tearing us apart. Let's actually pop our defensive AA. And you can just watch how many planes go down. We'll pop some torpedoes out there to help deal with the amount of secondaries that are spamming us right now. Alright, so we got some good damage on the Taiho. Got a couple torpedo hits. That's pretty good. More citadels. So the Freddy's down. And so will the Taiho in a minute. That should finish her off. Really? Alright, so I guess I was mistaken. But this one should finish her off, right? Yeah, there we go. Awesome. So now we're back into secondary range of Freddy. But we have bow torpedoes. So we should be fine in regards to that. Also, she just took a bunch of damage anyways. And then we just have Alsace. So honestly, I would still say that the 11-inch guns are better than the 15, but it's all up to you, really, on how, what works best with your playstyle. If you prefer the heavy-hitting quick salvos versus the slow over time, annoying, burning salvos, then yeah, go with the 15-inch. But honestly, I prefer the 11-inch. Now, the only real damage we've taken so far is by secondaries, and you can still see that I took quite a bit of damage just by secondaries. So you're not strong in that regards. Your torpedoes are already reloaded. Yeah, let's pop some into the water. I doubt it'll actually get there, though. It is possible to citadel battleships, like you can see there, a lot easier than it is with the 11-inch guns. But consistently, I like the 11-inch. Alright, and there we have ourselves a game. So let's see how we did with those. Alright, this time we had 258,000 damage, 1 ship sunk, 63 shell hits, 2 torpedo hits, 22 aircraft shot down, 12 citadels, 1 fire, 1 flooding, 1 capped base, 1 assisted cap, and 85 secondary hits for 4,000 base XP. All of that primarily was in armor piercing, barely any from fires, and just a few thousand in torpedoes. So the armor piercing shells can be quite powerful. However, I do prefer to burn my targets. It is very, very nice and comforting to watch them burn. So with that, that is the end of the video for this ship. However, it is patch day. So I do want to let you know about a couple of things that were released. Warspite was released. Yes, I already have her. I've not played her yet, though. I will play that in a moment. And then we will be reviewing her as soon as we finish up with the German cruisers, which we will be reviewing the last one tomorrow. Also, Guam was released. Again, I have her. Haven't played her yet. And there's no special consumable that I expected there to be, so I really don't know why they have this ship. But maybe I'll figure out something when I play her. And then they came out with a couple other ships to preview. USS Halford, which is a Fletcher destroyer with a seaplane. Now, these are actually historical. This ship actually existed. They removed the seaplane later on. But it's interesting that they have one here. How many does she get? Does she just get the one? She has 4 fighters. Well, I don't know where she puts them, but that's actually quite impressive. That being said, you do lose a torpedo tube and a 5-inch gun, and probably some AA mounts as well. But I'm excited to see what we can do with her. There's no other destroyer that has a fighter, so that'll be an interesting addition. And then also there's a Montella Galaxy Flame. I'm going to have to rename her, but my god, what is this? I don't even know if this is good or bad. I can tell you I don't like where they're heading with this. I do like the plane on the back, though. The plane is, like, the only good part in my eyes. So I'm not quite sure what this is going to be. Let's see here. Well, Montana Galaxy Flame is going to be a prism ship. And Halford is up for debate. It doesn't say. Interesting. Other than that, no other real interesting information. No release time for Kostroma or Veliky Novgorod yet. And then we will be finishing up tomorrow the German cruiser line with Magdeburg, or I should say Brandenburg, and then I have the sister ship, so Danzig, which is really, really fun cruiser. So thank you for watching, and take care.